Here are 5 design tips for your FLL competing robot. All that and more after the intro. In this video, I will show 5 different design tips for your FLL robot. So yeah. So tip number 1 is to bring the center of mass of your robot low and close to the ground so that your robot doesn't wobble as much. This helps in many things because if your robot wobbles a lot, it will bring inaccuracy to the movement of your robot. So yeah. So for tip number 2 is to make your robot as compact as possible. The most compact robot design in general is a box robot. In this example, it's very flat on the edges, and this helps you to square up to the walls, which helps you align with the border of the mat, and then you can align to different things and objects in this in the competition, in the playroom basically. Tip number 3 is for pinless attachments. I see this a lot. When people are switching from one attachment to the other, it takes a lot to get like the pins out from one attachment and to put the pins in. So for pinless attachment, there's like, you can have a gear that connects and then it'll be pinless, but it'll still wobble. So you can have the pin to axle, connectors, I forget what it's called, and you can connect them. That way it can't move or get off until you want it to get off. And yeah, for tip number 4 is to use 2 color sensors. This is so, as I talked before, to square up, not to the wall, but to the black lines on the competing mat and floor. That way you can align to it and move on it, or use it to align to some sort of a, like, mission on the FLL course, and you can align to it and do like turns on one light sensor. So for tip number 5, this is like last but not least. This is very important, and I see this happening a lot. So tip number 5 is cable management. For cable management, you need to have lots of concentration, even though it seems like a simple concept. But if you have your cables like noodles all over the course, you might hit a mission or an object, and it might like cause you to turn around if your robot's very light. But if it's heavy, it might go under the light sensor, and you might not be able to measure the color or light, or it might go into like under the wheels and then you'll stop all of a sudden. And it's very important. So yeah, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share. See you next time. Bye. That was not 5 minutes, was it?